morning to you.
Well, it's time to review something here a little bit, and I'm hoping this works out pretty good for you and me. I went out and I purchased the Rode Wireless ME, okay? You ask me, why did I do that? Well, I like making videos, but one thing that's always drove me crazy is I have to sit there and I play with the volume upstairs on my computer, and I've looked for other mics, and I had one, but the problem with the mic that I had earlier, and once again, they come from sources that I buy, and I try them out. Problem is, I have a protective case on my iPhone, which is right there right now that you're listening to, and I could never get the cord in for the microphone, right, the little adapter that I had, and I'll look up the name and I'll put the link of the one I had before. Anyway, that one right there was hard to plug in with my heart, my protective case. So I watched my favorite review person, which is Young360. Besides being very lovely to look at, she does very good reviews, and I know she probably makes money off of that. That's her life. This is not money. I don't make money off of this stuff. But I did wind up buying it, and it come with the adapters that I need. One for my computer, and the other one right now is being used on the receiver. I've got the transmitter, and the receiver is on the horseshoe mount of my phone up here. And I tested it out before I made this video. I ain't gonna lie to you. I wanted to see how well the range really is. Excuse my mess around the patio here. I'm projects before the wife gets home, you know, things I have to do. Anyway, it comes, like I said, with the transceiver and a receiver, both. And I'll get up close and personal with this before I leave. And for $100-something off of Amazon, that's why I buy my stuff. I always buy it at Amazon. I needed something when I do my review videos and all that. Now, when I ride my motorcycle, or my trike, excuse me, when I ride, I don't do the vlogging, you know, where you talk as I'm going down the road and, you know, explain things that's happening. That's not what I like. What I like is I make the videos with my Insta360s, and I like making music to them so I can hear the music going down the road. And then I kind of watch the video as I'm riding and listen to the music on the TV. And that's all it is a memory thing. And I, you know, document our chapter rides with the Southern Cruisers and anything else that I do. The microphone mainly is for if I do reviews, which this is one of two that I'm going to do today, probably. The other one's going to come up here pretty soon as the weather gets a little nicer outside, I think. But for the most part, I have things to do in the morning, like laundry and things, and get ready for that. And the sun's actually coming up. So what we're going to do is we're going to test this microphone out, just like they do on TV. And as you can see, or YouTube, that's where I get all my sources. Let me get up close here real quick. I want to show you. It's the Wireless ME. And we're going to pause here while I set it up. Okay. You can see me here. I'm talking to you as normal. So let's see how far this is going to go. I'm actually going to walk over there to Glenn, my target deer right there, and see how we go. So I'm going to walk about halfway, as you can see. And I'm going to keep talking a little bit about this microphone. This is why I do it. I don't want it to close. Am I ever going to be this far? Probably not. But I want to see if I can get out to Glenn out there and see if you can actually hear me as I do this. Like I said, I watched Young 360, and then there was some other reviews. All right, I'm almost to Glenn. I don't know if you can even see me by now, but I'm going to try to see this. Paid to do none of this stuff. It's just what I like to do. This is just one of many things that I want to review today, and I'll probably have the same shirt on, so don't get all fussy about that one. The microphone came with this little fuzzy thing on top of it. Yep. I guess it's to block the wind, and seems to be holding pretty good. I don't know. I want to see if there's any fluctuation in my voices as I get ready to talk to you. So, as you can see, I have the wireless mic from Rode, and I'm enjoying it very much. I enjoy the weather out here. This is a kind of a short review. I don't really have a lot to put into it other than what I'm going to use it. But you will see it in the next video as we talk about my next product. But for right now, we're going to talk about the Rode Wireless ME. I know there's other products out there. DJI has one. People compare that. Go to YouTube. Look for yourself, right? Compare what's good for you, what's valuable for you, and what really works. One thing I like about Amazon, I bought this. It's good. It works. It's great. And if I don't like it, I can always send it back. So, you know, there's no harm and foul in this stuff. I don't like planning to buy it, use it, and send it back. I actually want to use it, and I will use it here in the future for some more reviews. And what I would like about it is hunting, because I don't want to make a lot of noise when I'm in the deer stand, as you can see. So I kind of whisper right now to you, so maybe the deer don't hear me, and I don't have to speak up into the microphone. So that's the reason I got it also, because I make come, yeah, next Saturday's turkey season. I'll sit my stand with my stuff, and we'll talk turkey, pretty much. And then come deer season, we like to talk about hunting and everything that comes up in that wood area. But anyway, short review on the Rode Wireless ME. I hope you enjoy it. Well, that was a test, and I had to listen to it before I even talk anything more about it. And like I said, I hope you enjoyed the review a little bit. What I noticed, if my back was to the microphone and the transmitter here is in front of me, you don't hear it as well. So pretty much the transmitter and the receiver have to be in line for you really, really to hear me really good. The farther I got out there, which is from the camera, is a good 40 yards, okay? That's a good distance, really. I mean, who's going to be over there 40 yards talking to you? But anyway, at 40 yards, you could hear me when I'm facing you. If I have my back to you, it comes out a little bit less volume there, but that's okay. That's what it's all about, to test it out, to review it, to see how I like it. And so far, I'm going to tell you what, I give it 100%. I love it very, very much. And I forgot to mention the other two cables. You got these RC cable connections for different things. On the back of the box will tell you which one does what. You know, one's a 3mm, 5mm, goes to this connection and this connection. I don't know where I would use that at. Probably on my camera. I'm thinking that's pretty much with that my wife's ADD. I would use it there when I do videos using her camera. But I like my iPhone better. I really do like using my iPhone 13 for videos. It really works out good. And like I said, the other product that I had, it was good. It just didn't fit into my needs as well. So I guess you could say it was wasting money. No, it's not. It was something I used, and I might use it again. I don't know. It's a backup for this stuff. But for the most part, oh yeah, by the way, it comes with a nice carrying case to protect it. And the little fuzzy thing doesn't really work good too much. It doesn't stay on the transmitter. Every time I move it, it fell down. It's just probably I'm not putting it on right. But for the most part, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for listening to me rattle on about this. But for me, the Rode Wireless ME is a fit for me to use as my future production and videos and stuff that I want to do here. But stay tuned later on today. I'm going to be doing another video. And this one's a little bit different, but we're not going to be talking about the microphone as much. But we are going to be talking about something. So hang in there, and we'll get right back with you. Please, ladies and gentlemen, if you do like this video, hit the like button. And then, of course, after you like it, maybe hit the subscribe button if you want to follow along with more videos that I post out there. And to make sure you get notified, please hit the notification bell on all those. That will get you to my channel, and hopefully you like what you see and do. Like I said, it's nothing new. There's other videos out there, and I appreciate it. Young360 does an amazing, amazing job. And like I said, she's a great lady to look at. I enjoy watching her videos and listening to demonstrations. Do I buy everything she says out there? No, it doesn't fit my needs. Because after I watch her reviews, I do tend to pick it up. And one other thing I must tell you about charging these things, which I don't think another video covered, but let me cover it real quick. I got around thing like this, you plug into the wall and it has many USB ports. I found two cords, and that's how I charge my phones. I mean, these microphones before I use them. Apparently, I guess when it's on my phone, it gets charged too, but I'm not sure. But it wasn't a whole lot in charging. I had to go back and read the manual, but I wanted to cover that one up, and I need to make sure y'all understand. I plug it into a USB adapter, and I run the connection that fits into the mic, and it works great because I have many, many products, and each one of them have a damn cord that's different, which is unfortunate. But for the most part, I use the ones that I can to mix charging. So I charge them both at the same time, and I understand there's a case out there where you can drop them both in at the same time. The other microphone that I had, it had a built-in, as you store it, it charges it too. So anyway, thank you for watching my videos, and I hope you all have a great year this year.